Hi everybody and welcome back to my basement. Today I have something really cool to show you because I asked BDFPV some parts to do my Dyson Mini next build, basically the Acro version, and they sent me something super cool. And this is Beta Nano HD camera. BDFPV has already its own Beta 65X HD. You can buy it, bind it and fly. It's a 2S Lidl 65mm swoop and it's HD with this camera. But if you already have a 65mm, they sell also the conversion kit basically, and this is awesome. Let's see what's inside.
FBI, open up!
Perfect, so here we have the box. As you can see, it's the Beta Nano HD. Opening it, you will find the Beta FPV card, a set of screws with different screw sizes so you can actually adapt it to your drone of preference. Then we have a little canopy right here. This is super light actually and not bad at all. It's good quality plastic. Then we have the little bracket to hold the mount inside this canopy right here. And lastly, the star of the show. We have the BDFPV Nano HD camera. Look at this thing, it's so tiny, it's crazy. And this is perfect to fit inside a 65mm whoop. As a glass lens, I'm happy to see. This camera actually acts as your FPV and your HD camera. It's a split type camera. So, how do you connect? As you can see, there is the SD card slot right here. It's not locked or anything, but it's a really small drone, it will not drop. You can see a microphone right here, and if you turn it at the back here, there are the connections. So you have your button to do start and stop recording. Then there are three pads, 1, 2, and 3. And I was looking at the pads right here, and if you read what's written on them, it's super confusing, because in the first pad is written 5 volt and ground, on the second one 5 volt, and here ground and ADC. So I went on the website, because if you look at the card right here, you can find the instructions online. And so for more info, you can go on the BDFPV website right here. And if you scroll down, you can see it shows you the connection diagram. If you scroll down, it explains you how to connect the actual DAC. That's basically the way you connect it to your flight controller and to your remote. So as you can see, okay, it's up here. You can enter the camera OSD itself and you can change settings on it, like the frame rate or the resolution, I guess. Also like auto recording and stuff like saturation, sharpening and stuff like that. So I will have to connect also this connector. And here it says you have to desolder this actual connector right here. Or if you have a pin, you can have a pin going down it. I then decided to just solder it and to the DAC pin, which is the middle one, without removing the connector. If you go on the BDFPV website, they tell you to solder also to the LED pad of your flight controller, or just choose whatever free resource you have. Also beeper pad works. And follow the instructions really carefully, because it tells you that you have to go to your CLI and copy and paste basically the settings for your DAC to work. And you will see now it doesn't work on mine, because I am in Betaflight 4.0.6 and you need 4.1 at least. And you press enter and then just write save and press enter again. And here I found something super curious, because beneath this connector there is written Tiny Turtle 3. I don't know if you can see it. And Turtle is a camera made by Caddx. So maybe this camera was bought by BDFPV to use on their website. And this is produced by Caddx. That's my idea. I don't actually know, because there is nothing written on this board right here. And now it's time to take apart the Mobula 6 and put this in so I can try it on a drone. Bad news, today is another day and I've tried making this work together and I was really excited about Amobula 6 HD, but really the regulator on this drone cannot supply enough power to the actual board. I've tried, as you can see, soldering a battery lead to it and tried powering this camera through 3.7 volts and it doesn't work. And this is a huge minus for me, because if this camera is made for 65mm whoops, then most of the whoops are 1S, you know? So it kind of defeats the purpose to to accept minimum 5 volts and not 3.7. But I will put this project on hold for a bit, because I don't have any other way to power this. And I bought a step-up converter. So there are small converters, they weigh like 1 gram. And they push your voltage from 3 volts basically to 5. And that's what I need to power this, because if the regulator is not powerful enough on this, I will put an external one, so the board can receive its own power, you know, and not have issues. Because I've tried, it binds, it films, but once you actually go and arm the drone shuts off, and, you know, it's not flyable that way. But I have an actual plan B, because I found the Beta 85 Pro. And I know this is bigger and, yeah, you can put a real big split type of camera on it. But this drone is super light, it's like 35 grams. So this camera will fit nicely on it, and I will try. And since it's 2S, this camera can actually take input voltage from 5 to, I guess, 18 volts. So it has a wide range of batteries you can plug it to. Let's see how it goes. Remove canopy, camera, VTX, and FC. Then you want to solder the RC antenna on the other side, otherwise you will get in the way. And also remove the camera from the VTX, you don't need it anymore, because we will take power from the battery leads, and the camera wire will go from the Beta Nano HD to the blue wire that goes into the FC from the VTX. And then the DAC, we will take it from the LED pad, which is at the left of all the cables that go in the FC. Then we can reassemble it, and everything has its place inside the canopy, so it fits nicely. Screw everything in with the screw provided, and that's it. Align the board with the actual SD card, and it's ready. It's a real beauty. Look at it. Wow. I hope the ducks don't show up in the camera, but I think they will, because the camera is really wide angle, as I saw in my test videos. They do show up a bit, but you can crop them out. This is the raw MP4 footage from the drone. It's not bad. Stock settings. There is a bit of jello because it's windy. In the next episode, I'm gonna test different settings for the Nano HD camera, and basically test like different sharpening and saturation and stuff, and find the best image quality out of this. Maybe some kind of, you know, flat color profile, so you can color grade it later and get the best possible out of this camera. It's a little camera, but it has a lot of potential. Wrapping up this review, because a lot happened and there is a lot to talk about. The Beta Nano HD camera is a great little camera. It's 6.7 grams, so lightweight, and it can do up to 1080p, 60fps, so it's a lot. And the camera quality is pretty nice, I can't say anything about it. And I can't ask more from a little camera, remember how little this is. And this camera is supposed to fit your Whoop Side Squad. This is quite wasted on a 85. Even if being so light, the drone doesn't feel the camera on it. But where this camera shines is on the 65mm drones, and maybe even 75. But this is one of the biggest drawbacks also, because this camera cannot be powered by 1S, at least 5 volts, but regulator on these drones are not super powerful. So it's sketchy, because 99% of the small drones like this are 1S only, and the BFP one is 2S, but if you have the 1S one, I don't know. The regulators on them are not powerful enough to power it via 5 volts. So you have to get a step-up circuit. I found one on Banggood, then I ordered it, so I can't wait for it to arrive and I will try it on this. But that's 1 gram more, and on a 20 gram drone, it's 1 gram, it's a lot actually. So I don't know, I hope it will work. I will leave the link down in the description if you want to check it out. And other than that, it works great. It comes out of the box already configured, so you don't need to do anything. I cannot wait to actually move this camera from this to this, because hey, I want to fly a 65 HD. I really want to do the big step on the 65, because I did it on the 75 and it's amazing to fly indoors. You can film your cat under the sofa, you know, it's crazy. And for the 85 I have this, so I don't actually really need a camera on it. But it's fun, you can record your footage, and I mean, it's a really compact solution if you wanna do that. Not bad at all, good job BFP. As always, you will find the links down in the description. Stay safe and happy flying!